First of all, I would like to apologize because I was thinking about the wrong timetable. My colleague is at class right now, so I have to give her part. But well, I'm going to try to do it as best as I can. This project has been done with the Department of Prehistory of University of Granada, the Department of Criminology and Human Body Identification of my university, Isabel I, and my laboratory of forensic archaeology and anthropology. During the last 6 years, we have been working with the Archaeological Museum of Lucena in Córdoba, in southern Spain, in two particular sites. One linked with the last time of the Roman period, and another one during the change with the arrival of the barbaric tribes, well, Germanic tribes. During this period, we are working in Baetica, in the southern part. I'm pointing with the mouse right here. The place we are working at is located in the Baetica, and well, during this period, during the end of the Roman Empire, the rest of Hispania also had some consequences regarding the crisis of the 3rd century, which caused, in this case, the breakdown of the unity. Oh, sorry. The unity of the power that affected to the entire population at three levels: social, economic, and finally a religious level. After this process, during the last steps of the Roman Empire in our peninsula, in the Iberian Peninsula, the Germanic people start to arrive, and also to start to conquer some particular places in the country, finishing the conquer of the of our all of all the peninsula at the 8th century. Right now, this is during the last steps of the Visigothic, the Germanic tribes in our country. The country was divided in four big places. The vast majority of it is with the Visigothic reign. In the upper left part of the country, with Galicia and part of Portugal, the Suevo tribes were the place. And finally, during the last steps, we have some parts dominated by the Byzantine Empire, plus some tribes that never was conquered by anyone, Astures, Cantabros, and Vascones. In this case, the greater Visigothic force was concentrated in the vast majority of the country, and other peoples at the end of this period was trying to conquer again the Eastern Roman Empire from the Western Roman Empire, the one that survived during this place, but which means also. At the end of this period, with previously at the arrival of the Islamic people from the north of Africa, bring again instability, political instability, again another weakening of the former state. But on the other hand, the Arabic people, the Arab people, brought us more economic and more social growth in this case. But they also changed the unification, the religious context. In our particular place, we are going to in our particular investigation, sorry, we are going to work in two sites. One of them is called Cortijo Nuevo, is the one we are linked with the Roman Empire from the 2nd to the 4th century AD. In this case, it was discovered because one person was captured by the police because he was with a metal detector and a bag full of Roman things, Roman material. And after that, the police called the heritage department. They went there and make some archaeological surveys, and find the six were totally empty, but two of them was linked with a necropolis. In this case, we can see that the spatial distribution in this necropolis was practically in parallel, some kind of streets. But regarding the topic we are going to talk about is this necropolis for the burials related with adults has been created a hole in the ground, plus a gable roof and some tiles surrounding the burial. But regarding the infantile and juvenile burials, we can see that in this particular case, it has been created practically the same with some tiles at the upper part, but all of them were empty. This is the only way we have found these kind of burials. Maybe in order to be prepared for a future death, because they were very aware that the infant mortality and juvenile mortality were really high during this period, but not too much in this particular site, because we have found around 30-something percent of the individuals. We have been work in another site with this mortality even higher. And on the other hand, we have work in a second archaeological place called Cortijo Coracho, that was discovered because during the works of a highway between Córdoba and Málaga, the two capitals of both provinces, and during the same have been found 297 burials, plus one basilica that gave us the opportunity to create the historical context. We have documented some rituals linked with the pre-Roman rituals like ustrinum and amensa. Plus, we have documented some Visigothic and Byzantinum rituals. So, in this case, with a difference in the other side, the distribution has been changed, has been modified. They are not in parallel anymore. Plus, the orientation of the burials changed, because in the other side. They were always the head pointing to west. In this case, the head was pointing to sunset. So, because this changed slightly during the year, the location of the head in this case in every burial changed slightly too. So, this is a picture from the excavation. We see that they are not streets anymore. They are not buried in parallel, and also the slightly changed of the burial. Plus, similar to the previous period, they also create burials just for individuals, for people in development. Created with a hole in the ground and some bricks surrounding the individual, plus some gable roof created with some tiles. And in the same way, we have found several of them that were totally empty in order to be prepared when the person finally died. But in this case, we have more versatile kind of burials. We have found another kind of burials where is a hole in the ground directly plus some rocks covering the burial, but in this case with one individual. Okay, we have found some that the burial were reused, another hole in the ground plus some slabs of rocks over the burial, but in this case we can see one supine individual at the right, the last one to be buried, and all the individuals that were previously buried in this place were moved to the lower part of the burial. And also, we have found some individuals, some adult individuals in an infantile burial, but that has been reused as an ossuary for adults. On the other hand, we have found also some modification from previous burial linked with both in juvenile individuals and adult individuals. In this case, we can see that one of the burials were modified. It was created a new space at the feet of the original burial to bury more people. The upper part, we have found a juvenile individual, but in the lower part were found some spare bones, which means that it can be used as a kind of ossuary, like in the previous place, but like in the previous burial, but in this case has been modified in order to locate these particular bones. Also, we can see in some occasions that an adult burial can be divided in two or even more departments using a rock. We can see in the middle part of the burial has been located a rock in order to divide a big burial in two spaces. In this case, we can see one juvenile individual. Here we can see an ossuary for several adults, and the same here with one. Well, it's not in the image, but here we have one juvenile, and here we have another one during the process of excavation. This is the slabs of rocks that we used to find in the vast majority of the cases in this part of the necropolis. So, as a conclusion, we have found related with the juvenile and infantile tombs, right, in the necropolis, that we have found several changes. And during Roman times, we see that we see a parallel distribution in the necropolis. The orientation is stable, always pointing to the west, and also there is a planning of future death with the construction of burials that were found empty. At least all of them that we have worked at the moment are totally empty, including both adult, juvenile, or even child burials. But this situation changed during the late antiquity with the arrival of the Germanic tribes, the Germanic people. The distribution is obviously less orderly. Also, we have found some changes in the orientation, but coincidentally, we see that we have found some empty burials also for juvenile individuals. So the versatility is higher in this particular site, in Cortijo Coracho site, the one is linked with the late antiquity. In this case, we have found a specific burial for juvenile individuals, but we can see them empty in order to be prepared for future uses. They can serve with two or more individuals. In this case, we have seen two individuals from Eastern Europe, because they have some skull changes that not belong to the Western Roman Empire. Probably they were descendants from these German people, but also juvenile individuals with people who shared the normal features of the Western Roman Empire next to the Mediterranean Sea. Also, we can see that it can be used, these juvenile individuals can be used as an ossuary for adults, but we have another form to identify these changes. Some adult graves can be used, but the space they use is modified. Sometimes it has divided with a rock. Sometimes has been created a new space in order to accommodate more individuals that we're going to be buried in. Or finally, we can see even some adult individuals just used by a juvenile individual. So we want to give our acknowledgments to the Town Hall of Lucena, the place we are working at, the Archaeological Museum, and also the Heritage Department of Junta de Andalucía, where are these bones and this site we are working with. And well, almost 15 minutes. I hope I had the time enough for explaining everything.